very exciting. And you often have the artist, artists who have been working on very good assets that you get going on here. So, first, I would like to talk about the business event. It's actually a nice event that's worth trying to do. The purpose of this event is to organize more organizations to share their efforts to the others so we can get some discussions on where we can go and actually going and moving on to the conference on technology. In German. We have three presentations for the session. If you want to have a look at the proceeding, you can go to the website, the e-learning school, click at the SCI session, and we direct you to the actual ECIS talent website, which has the proceeding, all that proceeding, okay? So if you are interested, anyway, let's just go to the website. Okay, so the first talk is sentimentalities of the Burmese language using the disability representation of infra-based work. The presenter is a professor, Hashimoto from Kinshasa University.
Okay, thank you for the chair. Actually, you know, this is my student research, but I'm due to some unexpected budget problem, I made a presentation now. Okay, so anyway, the first, my introduction. Okay, first, actually, we are talking with less resource language processing. Less resource means that we have poor or no established data resources and established standard corpus or something, and also lack of tools like rock segmentation tool or post-tagger or other things. So, anyway, one of the good examples is a release or Lao. Or Khmer, so most of the ASEAN languages are categorized as resource language. And then, talking with these kinds of things, there are two ways. One is to develop standard corpus or to develop world segmentation tool. This is a standard way or a royal way, but it takes money and cost. The other side is to do without them. And then, our approach is the second approach. So this study tried to make a sentiment analysis of user articles written in Burmese, but then, in this case, instead of using the standard word segmentation tool, we employed variable length sentiment words instead of ordinary words. And also, variable length sentiment words are grouped according to the similarity of the distributed data expression, using the word to bag and draw in order to reduce the number of words. And then sentiment value of these words are estimated with the semantic orientation, Latin semantic analysis. Then we constructed a sentiment dictionary and made an evaluation of the our methods. Okay. So Burmese language is something like this. Okay. I'm sure you already know. Okay. And then about the distribution, the distributed word representation, which is part of the theme of this deep learning winter school. So basically for the evaluation, actually we didn't use deep learning technology. Okay. So don't get me wrong. So basically, we use the back-of-rules model for the final evaluation test for classification of news articles. Okay. However, Ngram word models that we are using will contain too many low-frequency words. So if we use the Ngram words and make a simple binary classification with those kinds of data for back-of-rules model, then the accuracy will not be so good. And so, thus we want to reduce them by grouping them according to similarity. Then, the question is, what kind of similarity we should use? Then, we employ distributed wording representation. Okay. And then, we compare the world to back and global. So, overview of research is something like this one, very simple. So, first we have sentiment annotated news article data. So we made a questionnaire survey for Burmese people, and then there are two ways. One is a baseline model, so an ordinary word segmentation, which we also developed last year. But then this ordinary word segmentation needs a lot of answer data as well as a lot of manual correction. So this is a baseline, but please remember that this takes a lot of manual cost. And then The other one is the N-promote segmentation. And then for N-promote segmentation, there are three models. One is the straight one, so without any word grouping, the simple one is element one. And also, we have two other set the using the word to make a global model for word grouping. And then after that, we made a set dictionary for each model, and then made a user article classification. So our data is actually very small. So please remember that this is almost a preliminary research, okay, not the finished one. So for data set, we used the 100 news article from opinion section of 7 day daily. This is the most popular newspaper in Japan. And then, what is the variable length n-chromed words? I am sure that all of you know something about n-chromed words, but then our method is variable length n-chromed word count. So it means that our n-chromed has different size. So usually, as you know, that the n-chromed word model, like bi-chromed word model, means that we regard all the two character string as a word. Okay, so this is a fixed size n-gram. But instead of that, we are making a variable length. Variable length means that we first start a little bit longer size, in this case a 15 gram, and then choose the most frequent one as 15 gram words. And then after that, we make the same thing at the 14 gram, 13 gram, 12 gram, like that. So by doing this way, even when some lengths of strings is a little bit longer, but occurs frequently, then we can be the same words. Okay. So this is a frequent and variable length and gram word segmentation. And then, like this one. So suppose that we have this kind of characters, and then first we chose a 15 gram. And then when some 15 gram words appears frequently in the data, then we regard them as words. And then change them into, for example, n. And then we can make the same thing for 14 grams. And again, pick up those frequent 14 grams as words until this time 5 grams. Okay. So this is a variable length n-chromed segmentation. And then after segmentation, we propose the use of one two bag and glob to reduce the number of n-chromed words. So actually, particularly for all the participants of this winter school, I think that most of you are expecting that the deep learning will be a very big model to solve some sort of big issue. But actually, what our approach is to employ some deep learning technique to part of the research method. Okay. So in this case, that we are using this word distribution model to reduce the number of n-gram words. But actually, at the same time, this is the first attempt to apply word-to-word model or global model to n-gram words instead of usual words. So baseline is, as I already told you, that CRF-based word segmentation. And also segment dictionary construction. There are a lot of different models, and this time we use this SOLSA. Please allow me because the time is limited. So anyway, we chose 8 positive seed words and 8 negative seed words, and then this equation making, this is not so difficult, that for some word I, the probability of the co-occurrence of these words are positive seed words minus this word co-occurrence with negative seed words. So this is a simple equation proposed by other people. Okay. And actual calculation is a little bit complex because we are using ISA. But anyway, this is not our equation. Okay, and then finally the classification is performed by combining the segment by So first, the number four is a baseline model, one segmentation. So in this data, the correct Burmese words are already contained. So in this case, as you see, that the accuracy and the precision is the best. So this is natural. Okay, this is normal. On the other hand, the F measure value is not so big, almost the same, but still it's not the best. On the other hand, actually, according to the small size of data, the best one of the F measure is the experiment one, which did not use well distributed well grouping. However, as you can see, that even when we use the global model, the result is almost the same. Okay, the result is almost the same. On the other hand, when we use the marketing bag, this is not so good. And as you can see, that the accuracy is very similar. So experiment 3 with GLOW has a very similar result with experimental 1. And some result like precision is better. Okay, so actually, we can think that experiment 3 achieved almost the same result, but sometimes a better result for any precision. On the other hand, one thing that model did not make a good result like this one. Okay, so this is the result. So anyway, as I told you, that an experiment 4 has the best accuracy, which is very much expected. However, please remember that usual segmentation employed language-specific characteristics, in this case the Burmese language. On the other hand, our model, variable n-gram words, has no language-specific characteristics. Okay. So although there's no language-specific word segmentation in experimental 1, 2, 3, actually their performance are almost comparable. And so that our result is not the best, but still almost comparable, particularly when using the GLOW model. In the case of word grouping, of course, GLOW is a bad. So one idea is that it seems that GLOW is more suitable than word bad, partly because GLOW is based on sentence structure, while word bad is based on simple word count. And then the performance of grouping may be high if we increase the data size, maybe. And actually, this is not maybe. We already did another experiment after the submission of this paper, but then we are enjoying a little bit better result. Okay. So anyway, our proposed method is not focused on only Burmese language, so this is some sort of a language-independent method for less resource language. And again, method does not need a language annotated data or other existing tools. So although the current result is not the best, still I think that this comparable result will have a good meaning. Okay, thank you.
Articles. But actually, we already have more than 1,000 unused articles, and we already did the same experiment for checking the result. And then actually, the result is much better. But the second thing is that particularly for making the sentiment dictionary, we need a little bit more data, and then we are having a little bit more data. So the first thing is that we are making the size of the data. This is the one thing. And the second thing is that particularly, currently this is some sort of a preliminary, very simple experiment. But then, now our second step is that we are making a little bit more tuning, like parameter setting and other things. And I hope that the final tuning will make the best result compared to other things. So this is some sort of the near future goal.
Thank you very much.
friend here.
Everyone, my name is Chris Nawat, and today we present about development of hybrid deep learning instance classification. For the first step of our research, so we would like to extract about sentences inside our fields, and for our first problem is to talk about how can we extract some sentences in articles in reasonable time, because nowadays, if you want to do research, you have to find an article or research paper, and you have to classify which word you have to take a look inside. And now, my research is you use CNN or convolutional neural networks. That is very professional, or you can call it is the state of the art in image recognition nowadays. And we use LSTMRN, that stands for Long Short-Term Memory Recurring Neural Network, which is the state of the art in sentence classification. For the part of CNN, we would like to use this technique to be a feature extractor and classify by LSTMRN. As you can see, two building images here. For the figure one, is CNN. They are convolutional layers around here, and the other one is known as TMRN. We have to classify each single layer inside this long structure. And next, for related work, we use our prior work dataset from the existing research that could work right. They're running across for automatic discovery success factors relationship that made full text articles research. So we have used this data set to improve in terms of recall acquisition. And for next thing research, they use 9 base and BARI and also TF-IDF and logistic information. But all of these none of the technique produced good performance in both recall and precision. So, for our challenge, we have to focus on the regulation region at the top right here to improve both of these by using deep learning. And next, here is our methodology. We start from our corpus. We have the existing corpus in SQL database, and we have to export it to CSV file, and then we have to classify between positive and negative sentences. That is a kind of supervised data set. We can separate two files like this. And then we visualize from pre-trained model called Global Vector Space that is developed by Stanford University. And there are 300 dimensional vectors and about 840 billion tokens. The many of tokens are about words inside a sentence. And we have to map between these our data set into word vectors. Like this, we call this database word representation mapping. After that, we have to use CNN in the journal feature extraction, because we would like to reduce or reproduce the set of features of those web features here, and then to produce to be a new dataset. And we use LSTM as the last step of our architecture, because ECNN for the last step is about multi-layer percent points. So we changed the last step to LSTMRN like this. And in therefore methodology, we separate our existing data set to two sets of 80% for training and 30% for testing. And about inside the data set, there are two targets. For number one is what we concern, and for zero is not target. And for the model representation, as I mentioned before about the recent slide, there are 300 dimensional vectors and 40 million tokens to particular local around inside the dataset. And we use standard feature for feature expression and LSTM for our classifier. Next, for result and evaluation, we use about 100 steps for training a classifier using LSTMRN, and for the loss function decrease by 50% after 50 steps of our loss function, and for the precision and recall by using the chain, we for the result is about 0.7 and 0.8 in both recall and precision. So for conclusion, we will propose a novel technique that use CNN as a feature extractor and long-term memory brand network that is the scale of the architect client. And the performance of word representation depends on the size of the tokens and vocabulary that can represent the nature of those words in the real world to the vector space. So if you like to improve the performance of text mining, I prefer to use very large corpus for if you want to train from scratch in terms of word vectors. And the other one is the hybrid technique can simultaneously improve in terms of recall and precision. However, we found that we have to spend a very long time, at least 6 hours, in order to do this architecture. So we have to focus on about GPU's performance by doing some parallelism in terms of computational performance improvement. And for our future work is to transfer the existing model across to other domains that we call transfer learning, because we can develop our existing model, or we call it pretend model, into other domains in deep learning easily. And for our tools is we use TensorFlow library Python 3 for research. Thank you.
What's the window size?
For the window size is 16 by 16.
So it means that one set of building layer, completion of building layer, will make the one fourth of the size of the
layer. Okay.
One simple advice is that we are not so sure about exactly how well this size will capture the language-specific features. So maybe you can also change the window size to know the best, better result.
Thank you.
I used to build a model in kind of more multi-classification. So I think that for the final step, it depends on for the final step, that's how you tune the model for multi-classification. So that in this kind of work, we have only about in class. So you just take a look for about the lines of the data set, that how does it collect data for each class in terms of multi-class classification. So about this mining, I think it could be a problem for classification more or less. Yeah, but you have to make balance between class, between each class.
And anyone who are working on multi-class like index mining, anyone of those who work on multi-class, just what is like two classes? I think maybe it's very easy. Maybe quite easy.
Yeah, because our focus is to extract our success factors. So just collect that by the expert that how can you choose success factors from articles. So just only two and one and two. Yeah. So it's very I think it's kind of a challenge to do multi classification.
This is the answer to the question that we will deal with. It's not about the emotional situation. This case, we're doing two classes. The reason being, we're using a very large pre-trained data set to develop statistics. So you imagine we're using CNN before. This is that we're using a very large pre-trained, for example, ImageNet, to do image classification for other cases we're interested in. So this picture is large enough, so I'm trying to find very large feature in the data. The other thing is, the idea that's extracting dominant features. And then from these features, we'll put it into one class, two classes, three classes, four classes. It doesn't really matter. In some ways, it matters. But it matters, of course, a larger training data set of your own, you will get better results. But if not, you still be able to distinguish in class and several features and class. So it's not a problem.
This is I have the rock together, Mr. Ebony and Professor and this assistant professor Dr. Mahasake. I divided my presentation in 5 months. First, introduction. Second, the network, the methodology, experimental and result. And finally, conclusion. Okay. Introduction. According to the global traffic, a small car report of the year 2016 global traffic report found that Thailand is the world number one of traffic jam. This type of problem in Thailand has caused many problems. For example, people do not drive despite district line, stopping on the road in no parking area, the lack of lane, also the sale of goods affecting traffic. In this article, we propose vehicle recognition system that stopping on the road in a non-parking area. We use technique local battery pattern, LBP, and the histogram of oriented variance, HOD, to classification the characteristic of personal car. In local parking, I use SPM to close the variable area in the window, slide portrait. Finally, the method used by majority world is to evaluate the car in local car.
So, I'd like to review that in future work, how to implement your system, your idea, your way of thinking.
Thank you for
your question.
I think there's a role in the back of high-end CCTV or CCTV app installed in the, on the
Good afternoon, everyone. I am the director of PAS for FED.
Of BEMD, so that from BEMD and here,
many research attempt to reduce commuting time. From this picture, although many research attempt to reduce commuting time is very high, and in effort, in some effort, some FBMD and FBMD have an effect. I will be focused by Chinti Chokro and Bora Sanya for reducing computation effort and an effect. From here, I will discuss if you go for impartial correlation for physical component analysis to decompose and then observe in the first shifting process. This method, with our iteration technique, in this picture, and then observe decompose by various efforts. I will be decompose high quality image and review and fix.
From BMD
1 to UIPF in and rest down respectively. Meanwhile, EMRD can compose monocomponent image directly. And EMRD can achieve high quality of monocomponent image. The comparison. The difference between EMRD and EMRD shown in this table. The first one is domain. IEMD decompose image on spatial domain. Meanwhile, EMRD decompose image in frequency domain. And IEMD decompose original image into a set of VMF from VMF 1 to VMF n and rest of respectively. Meanwhile, EMRD can decompose monocomponent image directly, and application for two methods. IEMD is suitable for illumination removal on target localized and deformation. And EMD application is suitable for target localized and tape detection. Although both IEMD and EMD are image decomposition techniques, they are root for different concepts. Therefore, they already produce the different decomposed image. This leads to different solutions for problem solving. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Samira Kasun from ICKARDL. Today I will present my research on topic is solicitation for foreseen investigation by arranging information gain and GA and building and working. My presentation is divided into five parts. First, introduction. Second, data set. Third, experimental framework. Fifth, experimental result and conclusion. The aim of this work is to select a small subset of policy screen that can accurately identify these needs. Today we are important economic animal in Thailand. The main commercial breeds including land race, rural, grass white and disabled. The breed is one of the important factors for growth performance and meat protein. So selecting the right breed for the geographical location is a very important issue. Breeds of pig can be grouped into two different categories, maternal breeds or terminal breeds. The maternal breeds are selected for replacement females, such as Landrace. The terminal side breeds are recognized for their growth and carcass quality and are usually used for terminal process, such as Durham. DNA is a chain of nucleotide carrying the genetic instruction used in the growth, development, functioning, and reproduction. That was physical trait of pigs are the result of the difference in DNA sequence, which are called SNP. SNP is a very big unit of DNA sequence that connects to a unique trait of an organism. For example, at a specific base position in the pig genome, this feature show you that its position CTA GTA appear of individuals, but its position occupied by GAG, this is a SNP. A good illustration can provide a good protein breed that grows fast with high production. This issue is there are millions of SNPs for a single organism. Today, a good way to address this issue is to use bioinformatics. Several classification changes for bioinformatics, such as HPM, decision tree and so on. At present, an aggressive classification model can only handle a small number of feature efficiency. Feature selection methods are used to improve classification accuracy. Feature selection applying in bioinformatics, such as ITS information gain, genetic algorithm, and decision tree. The data set used in this study consists of 677 samples of 22 breeds with 16,579 SNPs. From policy colonization of America and supported by biotech.
from Thailand. There are four steps of exploration flavor. First step, split data into training data set, 80% and testing data set, 20%. Second step, feature data, we use IT, GA, and a hybrid IT and TA to reducing the number of features into a subset of optimal features. First training this study used a linear kernel, SVM classifier and FIFO cross validation was used to obtain an optimal parameter to construct an accurate model. Last step is prediction to provide classification accuracy. First method is information gain. IT is a visualization technique of the type that can create feature distance from the relationship between feature. The cut point for feature section use an AO method. For example, left zero show information gain for each feature and right zero show feature per rank. Second method is genetic algorithm. GA is a particular class of evolutionary algorithm that will take it inspired by evolutionary biology such as selection, crossover, and mutation. GA rely on the classification method to select an optimal subset of feature that provide high classification accuracy. Each round for evaluation includes a classification step. Solutions are represented in binary as string of 0 and 1. For example, this picture shows two chromosomes or two populations with 10 genes. P1, the first bit and 9 genes are selected. P2, first, third, fifth, 7 and 9 genes are selected. Genetic algorithm has a problem to get feedback to local optimum. Solution, we set the mutation probability of 1 to 0, flip to 0.3 and 1 to, and 0 to 1 flip at 0.7. Hybrid IT and TA. We use IT to rank the significant level of feature. The cut point of feature selection based on AO method. For example, if the cut point was 300, the number of constructed genes in each GA chromosome would be a number no higher than 300. Experimental result the new home original study approach give an accuracy of 95.28%. While using DA alone give the highest accuracy at 94.8%. From IT alone, give accuracy 93.69% or 96%. IT approach give nearly same accuracy as the provide by TA, but use significantly fewer SNPs. Conclusion, SNP selection for positive transmission can be done by several feature selection methods and classifier. This study, we use IT, TA, and hybrid IT and TA to select an optimal set of SNPs for SPM to classify. But also provide a classification accuracy that was very nearly equal to the highest accuracy provided by TA alone approach. Thank you for your attention.
result, then as you see, the IG, only IG is the worst. And then IG plus GA is the second. And GA is the highest one, except for all features. On the other hand, when we look into the number of SMP, then IG chose 400 features for SMP. And then GA is one who's more than 2,000. So in this case, I'm not sure why IG plus GA only uses 250 with this number. My question is that the relationship with the accuracy and the number of SMP. Have you ever considered the relationship between the accuracy and the number of SMP? Because in most of the cases, if a machine learning method uses more reasonable features, usually it is expected that the result will be less. But this is not the case. So I want to know the relationship.
The objective for use accuracy alone, I try to get objective function, but I don't resolve. I don't know use term accuracy or how much? I don't know. Now I use accuracy.
So just to add on to that question, did you ever compare the runtime between each of the approaches? Which one takes the longest? The runtime of your algorithm to classify the big breed, which one took the longest? So did you ever measure the runtime of your algorithm? So at this thing that runtime may be another factor to take into consideration in choosing which method to go for. Yeah, so I just wondered if choosing like 200 SMPs will lead to much lower training time for your classifier.
ถ้าจะมีน้อยก็เร็วด้วยค่ะ อย่างรวมได้50%แปดสิบสลิปเนี่ยแปดพันสลิปเนี่ยใช่ไหมก็นานแต่ว่าพอเราเพิ่มเราเพิ่มความเร็ว
After doing the data preprocessing, we
through getting normalized in expression data. This data will process in parallel processes. As you can see on the left, it is segment in this process will match the normalized expression data with a G-set data. The G-set data is a group of genes that work together is a strict target in our body. In the G-set mapping process, there are two sub-processes which are gene mapping. This process will map the gene in each G-set data to the normalized gene expression data, and then we will pair the gene in G-set data. After finish the G-set mapping process, these data will plot the dissimilarity measure. In this cell, we make use of the BTCNA package to dissimilarity measurement. In this scale, as you can see on that picture, the result of this process, we will get the gene pair and weight of this gene pair. Let's go to the right side. On the right side, the normalized gene expression data will flow to identify significant gene in this step. We make use of ANOVA, which is a statistic method to find whether that gene is significant gene or not. In this step, we just label the gene as significant, non-significant, significant, or non-significant, and non-significant. And after that, we will get the result to visualize. In this step, we will get two plots. First one is profile, and another one is statistical summary graph. In the statistical summary graph, it contains the mean values, median, and it's contained the mean and median values. So this one is the result of this work. As you can see, we get three shape or profile. First one is reverse S shape, and the middle one is we call the norm shape, because most of the genes that we get is this shape. And the last one we call quarter shape. Firstly, we hypothesize that our reward is shared will give us the gene set that contain many related genes that related to the lung cancer. All the results was validated by four biological databases, which are
I will pull the database that contains the data about which gene caused the lung cancer or gene caused the lung cancer. As you can see in this table, the normal share tend to have a high percentage of related genes in GAP, Leverage, Delvig, and Cosmic Leverage. And the quarter share tend to have a higher percentage in K Leverage, but reverse S share tend to not very high as we hope before. So the conclusion of my words, these sample files are a useful way of visualizing gene coefficient and identification functional frame in gene set. And through profile analysis can be used with other tools to identify potential biomarkers for disease. So what's the name of my work? Develop concept to be a further case with more disease data set, more than lung cancer. And we will develop a more intelligent method for clustering the concept of art. And also, our method will be compared to existing method in order to show the variability.
Actually, Tom is very tired since she's the one who's maintaining the website of this winter school. So she doesn't get much sleep and she's happy to do this. So let's give her a big hand first. And the other thing is, this is actually not her main work that she followed up about using Neuron. Basically, one reason about using generalizing, nobody uses t-test for writing class, and nobody uses multiple classes at all. So that's not her main work, she was implementing it, so maybe she had fun answering some questions. Anybody else?
You have to do it. Okay,
The next extension is developing of an embedded biology for visualized
ECRs. You get 5 minutes.
Okay. My name is Isanka. Today I would like to present the development of an automated biological tool for visualizing dissimilarity within genes called expression network in biological clustering that I have 5 minutes to present today. This is a contribute a useful biological tool that help researchers in this area to reduce the time in biological processing. So, for my presentation, I have divided into four sections, including information methodology, result, and conclusion. Why we use an annotated biological tool? As present, there are many software libraries implemented in biological domain and overall library for gene network analysis that we found is called WGCNA, which stands for Web Gene Code Expression Network Analysis, developed in our language. According to WGCNA, that the output can be called into a graph in order to its characteristic, the main is mainly to identification of potential biofactor and time regression to set the time in data processing and visualization. For data set, we use lung cancer gene expression data TSE10072 that is downloaded from the expression Omnibus database and it consists of 107 samples that categorized into four comprising growing adenocarcinoma 58 samples and non-tumor 49 samples. In methodology, after you download the data set for gene expression Omnibus database and to identify biomarker and using gene dataset in the biological survey for gene transformation. It's divided into two groups and separated by analyzer to test the level significant and non-significant in each impact and categorized based on the threshold that is defined in value less than and equal to 0.05. And next, we perform the gene expression network analysis. It includes different correlation that generate a whole term that which the WGCNA is used as the default. We use the beta equal to CSTAT enough to work with analyzing the gene co-expression network. And then, 2D SLP network topology and compute similarity between genes using topological overlap measure dissimilarity will be useful scaffolding for analyzing this order that can describe how genes pass visualize with gene code expression network. For the result, as this speaker, we demonstrate practical endogram for the fatty acid metabolism pathway. That it consists of gene pair that are categorized into each pattern. The value of each gene pair is based on the dissimilarity correlation for clustering. Based on the results, so we propose the automated tool that can perform exploring genes expression and notation, significant tagging genes correlation with scale-free network, topological overlap visual calculation, dissimilarity genes co-expression network, hierarchical clustering visualization within a single byline, and we
100% you notify me.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Vijayaraya. I am the first year PhD student of Computer Education and Faculty of Facial Education at Kingwood University of Technology and Bangkok. Today I will present my research. The topic is an adaptive learning system based on computational learning. To enhance learning achievement concept. There are three parts in this presentation. First, introduction. Second, the construction of model. And finally, the expected result. If you have any question, please ask me after this presentation. Let's begin. First information, e-learning is learning utilizing electronic technology to access educational curriculum outside of traditional classroom. In comparing e-learning and classroom, often students need to recognize their own learning style and make e-learning to these two formats. Adaptive learning is a computer-based and online educational educational system that modify the integration of material in S4 to student performance. But there is another factor that we consider in our approach is learning style. Feminine and male, feminine and male. Support very style of learning by considering all attitude. Developing tool for technically visual, oral, visual, and kinesthetic. There are 16 questions for the classification of 4 individual learning style to be able to know learning style. From previous slide, we conclude our work for them to be able to develop an adaptive learning system that can teach the learner with their different style of learner without input any information or taking our questionnaire. Before using our system, and we also present the content with professional work and not just one. Let's see what we propose in our model. This is our concept of model. It's a development of adaptive learning system based on professional work, enhanced learning achievement. The model can be divided into 5 modules. 5 modules as shown on this slide. User interactive user interactive learning model, content module, and content module provide learning material to adaptive learning. Adaptive module get information from content module and expert module to generate lesson. The learning is also in assistant module which provides information to expert module to analyze the best combination of the research question. If the content module is stored the content of the lesson, he has exercise during the course and the course test and the exam at the end of this chapter. The practice of the lesson is created and shown in the work learning model, which consists of visual, oral, read, or write, and kinesthetic. The content of the lesson will be created based on the learning style and the goal to deliver the adaptive module to the learner according to the aptitude at the system analyzed. Next, this is the adaptive module. It obtains digital form expert module. Being able to classify professional work, it will then apply the learning style and test form the content module to generate the next chapter for the learner. And next is learning module. This module representing course material exercise during the course, details and bonus score for each lesson and the final exam score after complete and content. At beginning, students will come to the first lesson and take the test, then students will choose one of four variations on the examination of the content, and then conduct the student according to the student presentation format. During class, there are exercises on each topic that are taking. Students will be required to support at least 50%. The system will allow the next lesson until all the topics in the lesson have been completed. The system will retain the learner's behavior to analyze the presentation of the learner model in the next chapter. and achieve a balloon. If a collection of inhabitants of Sweden who use the adaptive learning system is consisted of success learning which is the number of times in the situation of the learning pattern that the score of the exercise is more than 50%. Learning curve which follows the progress of learner from the first question to see the development of learner from the adaptive system. We use the PTS and PTS score to find the learning achievement from the adaptive learning system. The efficiency of the lesson was determined by using PTS score and the random exchange score. All of the information will be forwarded to the expert module for further analysis of the learning and create a summary report of the system used by the learner. If expert module is a time analyzed behavior of students who have chosen the learning style in the lesson, exercise score and post-test score are analyzed as classification of appropriate learning style for the learner. In the next talk, for the learner in the next chapter, as for the ETLS system, if you learner behavior data can be used to classify learning style of the learner, such as the 4.5 or vector machine algorithm, intelligent system classify learning in the form of percentage of 4 aspects of one's learning style. And subject that the adaptive learning system is able to improve learner achievement because the course content can be adapted depending on the learner's ability. If research compare the pattern with the sample using the one questionnaire and the book using the classifying learning model in the adaptive learning system. Okay. Do you have any kind of suggestion?
Actually, many students understand that even when
contributed to improve the student learning. Actually, when you write journal paper or some, it's not enough. You have to pinpoint which factor in your system contributed to the learning best quality. Okay, so the importance in my advice is when designing the evaluation test, you have to think a lot to divide all the features included in your system independent. And then design each experiment to check only one or two factors in a way that other factors can be ignored. And I think that your goal, your teacher, already understand my point, so you can discuss with your supervisor later. Yeah.
Okay.
Start to have the